go, Matty. Next fight.
Toe of the tape, William Wang, 31 years of age, weighed in at 72 kilograms last night. Takes on the 26-year-old younger opponent, Nick Walsh, who only weighed at 69.1. So Nick Walsh giving up nearly 3 kilograms. It's going to be a great fight. Let's go to John DiMicoli, centre of the cage.
Ladies and gentlemen, bout number 10 of the evening, fighting out of the blue corner, Willie Wang.
Welcome William Wang to the cage. Josh Warner, some background on this 31-year-old.
Yeah, look, always wanted to be a fighter and then basically made the decision a long time ago that this is going to be the path he wanted to take. Got the opportunity through Wimp to Warrior to test out the skills that he currently has. Look, he's a really, really tall guy. So, again, if he's been, you know, tutored properly, which he no doubt has through the extreme coaches, he's going to want to use the reach in this fight. Use the arms, use the legs, keep your opponent in the distance, keep him in that pocket, and just pick him apart.
He's got a perfect stand-up fighter body, hasn't he? Those rangy arms, you know, good sort of physique for knees, athletic.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, if he uses that correctly, then he can keep your fighter at such a, your opponent, sorry, at such a distance where it minimises the risk of taking any damage. So if he just keeps the jab in their face, keeps the thrust kicks out there, use the leg kicks when it's open, then, you know, he could be really successful in this fight.
And we welcome William Wang, blue corner.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, Nick Walsh.
We're gonna skate to one song, one song. Bless your heart, motherfuckers, my friend.
So I ball so hard, motherfuckers wanna find me. First niggas gotta find me. What's 50 grand to a motherfucker like me? Can you please remind me? Ball so hard, this shit crazy. Y'all don't know that don't shit
face. We welcome Nick Walsh. Walshy, known by his colleagues, to the Melbourne Pavilion for the first ever time. How cool and calm and collected does this guy look?
Yeah, he was actually here really early today, one of the first fighters to get here, and he was, man. He was really relaxed, you know, prepared well. The last 6 months have been great. He spent a bit of time at Renegade with Cal Potter as well, you know, one of the best martial artists in the country right now. So throughout this Wimp to Warrior experience, he's also expanded his horizons.
Yep.
And he's ready to go.
Definitely right there, Josh.
It'll be interesting to see how he tries to negate the height and reach disadvantage it'll have here, though, Matt.
Yeah, definitely. It's going to be a tough fight. I mean, this guy, you know, sometimes you see a fighter, they look like a fighter. He's coming in smiling, laughing. No doubt he's been in a few little tussles before. He spent 6 months at Extreme Mixed Martial Arts.
Look when they go past each other here. Just look at the height difference.
Yeah, it's a big height difference. And that confidence there, Johnny DiMicoli, centre of the cage.
Ladies and gentlemen, your following contest is bout number 10 of the evening. 2x3-minute rounds in the MMA welterweight division. Your main charge in centering, Mr. Mark Cook. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a retail salesman standing 192 centimetres tall, an official weight of 71.9 kilograms. Fighting out of the blue team and representing West Melbourne, ladies and gentlemen, Will Wang.
Big Willie Wang.
And across the cage, his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a finance broker, standing 178 centimetres tall, an official weight of 69.9 kilograms. Fighting out of the red team, representing Brunswick, this man is the pride of Brunswick, Nick Walsh.
Nicky Walsh, the smaller session, very cheeky.
Hey, set a ring.
Mark Cork, he loves a chat, this man.
All right, guys, we've been through what's expected of you at the back of the rules, so listen to my instructions at all times, defend yourselves at all times. Touch gloves if you wish, go back to your corners. Good luck, guys.
Nick Walsh gave up 3 kilograms, but God, Wang, he's so many inches taller, at least 4 to 5 inches, Josh.
He's given up way more in the height and reach here, and we're just going to see how Willie will choose to use this advantage.
The John Jones star, Rashad Evans, made it famous. And
it's just the Thai style for Willie, look at the Thai style.
He looks confident.
Oh, bang early on. Great body kick.
Yeah, Wang was good. Got to come in with his chin a little bit lower though, Walshy.
He does, and he's got to try and break the distance. So stand in the pocket like that, or good combo.
Great start by Willie Wang.
Oh, big power big right. Shot. Oh, and two again. Big shots.
Well, he knows that right's going to land, and again.
He's loving the right. Oh, five rights.
Wang's in trouble.
He's eating punches.
Oh, beautiful front kick. That would have knocked his head off.
He's got the standing hammer fist.
What a start to this fight, Josh.
Here we go now. Now he's using the knees. He's going to use that height and reach advantage here.
Great perseverance by Walsh. He circled him probably the whole cage twice.
Kid's got
to chase
guts.
Him.
Got guts. And the takedown, the throwdown.
He's fighting a bigger man with more reach.
He's in the mount. He's got his back.
What a start by Walsh.
He's back. Is that under? If that's under, it is under. No, it's on his chin.
Yeah, it's on the chin there.
So this hurts, and he can finish.
Cranks it.
Can.
Just doesn't want to wear out. Josh, your thoughts on this?
You only got so long before you give it up because your arms exhaust really quickly. And I just had a front row seat to that. That's on the chin, so it's not under his chin right now.
And William Wang landed some big shots on Walsh Shirley, and there was those big rights that rocked Wang. But Wang kept on peppering his own kicks and offense as well. So very good fight.
You almost want to see these two stand back up here and have another crack because that was fun.
Great tactic by Walsh. All of a sudden, the size difference goes here.
Well, that's right. You're pretty much the same size on the ground, aren't you? Mom, work it.
Yes, turn. Wang trying to turn him around here.
If he turns over, he's going to really hurt Walsh's feet. So you almost want to flip. When he's got his feet crossed like that, that's bad technique. So flip over, and he'll have to break that hold. You also give your back up, though, of course. So you've got to be careful there.
So your advice on Walsh here, what should he
be
doing?
That's under the chin now.
Ooh. Let it go.
He's going to go to mount, and here comes the
big
punches. Big punches.
He's got under. Under now.
That's way under.
Yep. Wang is in big trouble.
He's in huge trouble here.
Oh, he's in a lot of trouble, Willie Wang. Great fight back.
He's got a good wrist control, so wrist control saved him again, but only saved him for a small period because here comes some big punches. Bang.
Some great aggression by Nick Walsh.
That side of the gloves got way less padding. Oh, good shots in the ears.
Good rights and left there by Nick.
He can buck him off here, though. He can buck him off.
William Wang just needs to survive this first round.
10 seconds to hold out.
Oh, good kick. He's telling him.
Calling him on. Look at these two.
He's teasing William Wang.
In each other's faces between rounds.
Wow. He has personality, this Nick Walsh. He copped the 2 leg kicks. He said, bring it on.
A bit of Tito Ortiz about him, to be honest. A little replay here. Some really good exchanges. That's a big shot.
That were the rights that rocked William Wang.
Anything less than 8-ounce gloves and that fight was over.
Yeah, for sure. It just seemed like he couldn't get away from the right overhand, could he?
No. But then smartly went the takedown and then dominated on the ground.
Yeah.
It was a big ground. 3 or 4 times it was real close to the rear naked choke. Dominated the ground and pound. And then gave him a bit of in-your-face style when the round finished. So he was already getting round two.
Really loved his aggression there on Nick Walsh. You know, when he was on top of him, he was trying things. He wasn't just trying to survive and hold a dominant position.
All right, second down.
And he looked
quickly,
for the finish. He looked for the finish the whole time, which I really like.
Come on, second down, 1-4, guys, quickly.
Marky Cook going absolutely nuts here. Nick Walsh taking on the taller William Wang and the heavier William Wang, who was rocked halfway through that round. Nick Walsh gets the chocolates for me. 1-0.
This ain't going to go to the end here. Watch this. There's no way this fight goes to the end of the second round.
Oh, and Walsh again, big takedown.
Guillotine hasn't got it and won't get it from there.
Oh, wow, he's got...
No, he won't get it. Can't get it from there.
Got the longer legs to try to get himself up if he can release that
hammer
left.
Fist. Good hammer fist. He's got to do something off his back this time. So again, open guard. He's got room to explode if he wants that. Longer legs too are great for submission. So if he can, you know, get into a position where he can throw the legs up for an armbar or a triangle.
For sure.
Or he's going to try it. Oh, look at the referee. Don't take
it. Oh, big punches.
Full mount. If he can posture here again, big trouble. The little right hands are very effective in his fight so far.
Yeah, he's very busy when he's on top, Nick Walsh.
That's the right word, Matt. Busy is the right word for Walsh.
Thank you. Great to be here. Our last fight night two of 2016, Josh.
It's been a big 2016 as well, so this is a fitting way to end it.
John DiMicoli, an amazing job tonight too. He's joined us in the commentary position.
Mom, work it. All right, so...
Wang spent on the bottom there. This looks like his spirit may have been broken a little bit. Josh, is that a fair call?
Yeah, bad for Wang. He probably lost the first round and he's losing the second round right now. And he's eating some punches, which never helps.
Yeah, he's eating a lot.
Good shot.
Great effort, Daybot.
Big shots. And look at the high mount. This is over. Ref will stop this. Oh, he was so close.
Oh, yeah, that hurt.
He has to stop it. There's no...
Wang trying his hardest to fight back.
Twice the referee's gone in to put his hands in and pulled away at the last second. Twice.
Defend or I'll stop it. Come on.
Tell him to defend or he'll stop the fight.
He's eating a lot of punches here.
Great heart by William Wang, though. Oh, beautiful one, Nick Walsh. Well trained. That's great.
Yeah, pulls him back in. Full back control. Start to work the rear naked. Couple of ear punches to soften him up as well. Dominant round two so far. For very young, but I tell you what, very impressive, Stephen Reed. That was back of the head. Again, arm under. So hard to finish with the 8 ounces on your hands.
Very impressive, Nick Walsh.
But he's flattened him out again in full mount. He'll posture and he'll rain down punches once again.
Very impressive kid, Josh.
He has been, yeah, and really impressed by him so far.
You know, I've got no doubt he's had some sort of training outside the 6 months, but really only ever spent the 6 months in mixed martial arts gym, and well done.
Yeah, we did mention, you know, the gym affiliation there with Renegade as well, doing a bit of work with Cal Potter, so probably a little bit more advanced than some of the others that we've seen so far, but having said that, he's
still
put the extra work in, and full credit to him.
Correct. Nick Walsh and Callum Potter, one of the absolute greats of MMA across the country. He'd be watching proudly. Huge fight for Nick Walsh.
Really impressive for Nick Walsh there. Really, really impressive. And bucked him off too. He's not happy. Old Wang here, I tell you.
And kudos to William Wang, though, for surviving. You know, he copped a lot of punches, and we'll look at this second round. That was a big takedown, Josh Warner.
Yeah, straight away, the takedown was effective. Got back into that ground and pound position. Some heavy hammer fists, some really good right and left hands. Still threw up the submission attempt, so he was looking for the rear naked chokes when they arose. Dominated round two, won round one. So for me, this should be a decision victory. And a really impressive one for Stephen Reed. We'll see more in the replay here. There's some big shots, even with 8 ounce gloves on. Those shots still hurt. Hammer fist, bang, bang, bang every time. And a bit to see where Stephen Reed goes from here. Based on his performance, I'll very easily see him working his way through the amateurs into a professional debut somewhere down the track. John DiMicoli, center cage, for the official announcement.
Hold on, guys. Face front.
Ladies and gentlemen, after two rounds of action, we've gone to the interactive scorecards. Your winner, red corner, the Pride of Brunswick, Nick Walsh.
Nicky Walsh, what a fighter, mate. You did not walk by day first timer there. I know you trained with Colin Potter. You know what? He landed some good ones early. Felt like he woke up a sleeping giant, mate. You were absolutely sensational. Dominant victory. He didn't, you know what? He didn't tap out. Couldn't, at the end, he didn't get stopped, but you won a great fight. Dominated a taller opponent. Congratulations.
Thank you, mate. Thank you to all my family for coming out.
Close, close.
Love you all. Much respect, Will. Good stuff. Yeah.
Nick, I know you're exhausted, mate. A great effort. What would you say to the people about your experience? 6 months of hard training every morning.
I know some people from Hexa here. Now you can sign me up. No problems.
Beautifully done. He said he wants to get signed up in a big promotion here. Hex in Melbourne. We hope to see you again. You don't look out of order. Congratulations, Nicky Walsh. Shonda McCauley with a very courageous William Wang.
Mate, very courageous. Willie, mate, you ate some big shots. He had your mount for quite a while, mate. You have a never-say-die attitude, mate. Should be very proud of yourself. 6 months in the cage. Mate, well done. Bad luck on the result.
Yeah, no, unfortunately, I couldn't come off with a win for the blue team, but... I worked hard during the 6 months, so it was really good.
It's a long way from where you are normally as a retail salesman, but tonight in the cage, mate, you should be very proud of yourself, and I'm sure the team in the blue team will be very proud of you, mate.
Okay, yeah, just wanted to thank all my coaches, everyone in the blue team, my wife, Stephanie, and yeah, just everyone who for coming here today.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for Willie Wang.
Okay, we've got the lovely Michelle Kimberly, Georgia Little into the centre of the cage. Michelle going for Miss World next year, looking forward to that. We've got some live auctions.